morning. Yeah, it is a good morning. But I have to tell you, I do miss the old norm. I miss when I would get ready for work, my kids would get ready for school, and then at the end of the day, my daughter would go ride horses and my son would go play basketball, and I just liked the rhythm of life. But you know, funny thing about life, riding horses is apparently an essential. And so that part of life was the one thing that remained constant exactly as it was, because the horse had to be fed and the horse had to be walked. And so I liked that. I like some sense of normalcy. And then all of a sudden, even that normalcy got shaken. It's the craziest thing. But where she rides, there wasn't enough space for them to do social distancing properly. And so all of a sudden, they couldn't have people there all the time. And so here's what happened. We were all wondering what was going to happen, who was going to feed the horses, who was going to walk them. And out of nowhere, somebody called and said, you know what? There is a place where you could bring a bunch of horses and have them be here for the rest of this time. And it's about a 40-minute drive, and I really didn't have that in my plan. In fact, I keep finding out that I have a plan, and I just keep thinking, God, I have the plan, here you go. And he says, no, that's not the plan. And even when I make changes, he says, no, that's still not the plan. Anybody else feeling the same way right about now? I know you are. But here is the thing. We got in the car yesterday morning and we were driving down to this new place to take the horse. And out of nowhere, my little girl looks at me and says, wow, Mom, this is really beautiful. And I looked around and I was like, wow, it really was a beautiful drive. And as we got closer, she said, there's a lot of land right here. And I thought, wow, when was the last time that I was thankful for something as simple as land? I was reminded of the sermon from this past Sunday when Chap said, and Jesus chose to reveal himself to Mary, but why? And it was because Mary went looking for him. And that hit me right between the eyes when he says it, because I was like, she went looking for him when there was no hope to find him. She went looking to draw close to him just because that's all that really mattered to her. He didn't need to be in any certain form. She just wanted to be close to the one that she loved most. And so it was just a real attitude check for me to look around and go, you know what? I get to take a little drive with my daughter. I get to see beautiful scenery along the way. And God has provided that. And so we get there and she goes over and she starts setting the horse up in his stall. And I just take a little walk around. And here's what I saw. Here, I'm going to show you just a little piece of it. So this is a ring where normally there would be people on horses, and they would be jumping over these hurdles. And the hurdles are, some are close together and some are higher than others. And the people that train for perfect timing so that they can jump them without the horses knocking a pole off or touching the pole even. And it has to be done perfectly. And their whole hope is that they will get the perfect ride and come out at the end across the finish line and hopefully get a ribbon. And I looked at those hurdles that no one's jumping right now, because jumping, not an essential. Taking care of a horse, yes, very important. But training, no, that has to stop like everything else right now. And yet, I looked at those hurdles and I thought, God has been training us for every hurdle we are facing right now. He was even so great as he brought the pandemic in the middle of Lenten season, when we were supposed to be drawing closer to him anyway. He invited us into this time to say, hey, listen, things are going to get a little bit hairy. I'm going to remind you that I know what the hairiest of hairy looks like, the worst of the worst, and I went through it for you. And he went through it, and then he rose from the grave to bring us total hope, but also, most of all, to show us, A, we were worth dying for, and B, there is nothing that he can't conquer. Nothing. This pandemic, nothing to him. How we choose to get through it, everything to him, everything. And so the hurdle of, oh my goodness, there are changes in jobs. Oh my goodness, there are changes in food supply. Oh my goodness, there are changes in how we care for people. It is the story of what comes next after the resurrection. So after the resurrection, things get back to normal a little bit, and Simon Peter and Thomas, they go out with some of the other disciples, and they're fishing, and all of a sudden, they're catching nothing. They're kind of probably having a bad day, thinking, this is not what we had planned. And out of nowhere, Jesus appears at the side of the water, and it's crazy. He appears there, and they look over, and they're like, oh, it's you. And they're shocked again to see him, shocked by his presence. And he says, hey, guys, everything's good. Throw your net on the other side. And they're like, no, we got this. We've been fishing and there's no fish today. We got it. And he's like, no. Throw your net on the other side of the boat. And they're thinking, what a stupid idea. But they do it. They go ahead and they throw their net on the other side of the boat. And all of a sudden, an abundance of fish come out. An abundance of fish. And you know what he says to do with it? Go share it with those who don't have any. You see, he is going to give us abundance of blessings. It's going to be in many different shapes and sizes. And we say, no, this is how I help. I do this. And he goes, nope, that was where the net used to be. I want you to throw it to the other side. I want you to do things that you have never done before. I want you to do something that is outside of your comfort zone. And so I don't know what you're going to do, but I will tell you this. I'm going to look for him everywhere. We've started a new challenge with the children of St. Andrews, and we are asking them to play this game called I Spy. And if you spy something totally different that is amazing that is going on right now, then you're supposed to share it. And share it with us, and you can send it to the address that Scott Cody puts on the screen right now. If you have something amazing that you have seen, please send it. Send it to the address that Scott puts on the screen right now. And let us know what you see too, because you know what? I'm seeing Jesus bigger than I've ever seen him. Do I know that we still need a cure and we still need things to get back to some sense of normalcy? Yeah, but I guarantee you this, he's got a new normal and his plan is always good. But we will only find him if, like Mary, we are the ones who look for him. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for who you are. Lord, it is hard. And you say, I know, I've done hard. Thank you, Lord, for what you endured for us and that you remind us that we're worth it. We love you and we give you all the praise and glory in advance for what you are going to do through this. And may we be the people that everyone says, I don't know what it was, but they had steadfast faith and it was unshakable. In Jesus' name, amen.